Vanakkam. We are here to celebrate the lives of heroic martyrs, the freedom fighters, the liberation tigers of Tamil Eelam. The defeat of the LTTE was to open the door to the genocide against your people, and a genocide which continues to this day. The continuing rapes, the continuing torture, the continuing extrajudicial executions, the land grabs, the sea grabs, all in the name of the Sinhala military occupation of your homeland. The genocide is ongoing. It has not ended, nor will it end unless we are able to break the unholy alliance between the Sinhalese state and the international great powers that support the genocide, who control the United Nations. How can we do that? Although the times are desperate and difficult, we really have to think through a new strategy, because I think that it is only by making common cause with the oppressed peoples and nations of this earth that we will be able to break the conspiracy of the oppressor states. There are those who put their faith and their hopes in the United Nations. No doubt that those collecting the evidence have been sincere. But there is already a mountain of evidence to convict the war criminals 10 times over. And the evidence that the United Nations is right now collating will be changed or manipulated to fit the story of the United States and the UK. And that story is to blame the victims for the crimes rather than the perpetrators. They will distort the reality and the evidence so that they have a result which puts equal blame on the LTTE and the murderous military machine of the Sri Lankan state. And there are those who put their faith in the forthcoming elections in Sri Lanka, and they hope that the Rajapaksa Brotherhood will be deposed. There is no doubt that Rajapaksa and his family are war criminals. There is no doubt, however, that all of the top generals, like Fonseca, all of the top ministers, like the ones who just resigned, are equally responsible for the war crimes. They are war criminals as well. I cannot see a way forward to elect one war criminal in the place of another when both were in charge of conducting a war of genocide against the Tamil nation, when both continue to support a unitary Sri Lankan state and the continued domination of Tamil Eelam. So where is their hope? Where is there a way forward? Hope lies with the oppressed peoples who themselves are confronting an unjust system in the world today. With the oppressed and exploited, we can find common cause. With the people of Kurdistan, with the people of Palestine, with the Palestinians, with the African Americans who have seen in Ferguson, Missouri, that the system gives no justice for them either. To make common cause with the families of the disappeared students in Mexico, to make common cause with the oppressed who are also, like yourselves, on the front line of an unjust system, who have got no justice through the United Nations or any of these machinations of the international state system. And hope also lies with decent-minded people around the world who only need to hear your story, to hear the truth of what's happening in the Tamils today, to give you support and sympathy. I commend, for example, the book by Trevor Evans. It's in English, but everybody should be telling their English reading friends to read this book. It tells the truth about the atrocities. It tells the truth about the continuing torture of Tamil people today. You must tell people about the Permanent People's Tribunal. And finally, you must tell people about this report by Phil Miller, because this details for the last 50 years or more since the Sri Lankan state was created, the role of the British politicians and military and their complicity in the dirty war against the Tamil nation. There is hope. There is a way forward. That lies by fighting the vested interests, and the vested interests including at the United Nations. We remember the Tamil martyrs as a way of rededicating ourselves to the struggle. We remember the Tamil martyrs by pledging to continue the struggle. There is hope. There is a way forward. Long live the martyrs. Long live the struggle. Long live the unity of oppressed peoples. Long live Tamil Eelam.